Our victim was reported missing on Tuesday, December 24, or December 14th. From that point on, missing persons had conducted, began to conduct their investigation as a missing persons case. There came a point shortly thereafter that missing persons and the homicide detail came together, began to look at the case and conduct our investigation based on some things that that we had found and some tips that had came in. We know that our victim was last seen on Sunday, December 12th. We did locate the vehicle shortly after that vehicle was processed. And as a result of a tip that came in early yesterday, that led us to a location in the downtown area where we were able to discover some human remains. As a result of that pretty reliable tip and the discovery, we were able to have enough probable cause to make an arrest on a Jason Omar Griffith, who was the ex-boyfriend of our victim. He is currently housed in the Clark County Detention Center, and our investigation is ongoing. There may be additional charges placed on him, and again, the investigation is ongoing, and we'll see where it takes us from there. So based on that, I'll be able, happy to answer any questions that I can for you at this time.
Where exactly was the body found?
The body was found in downtown Las Vegas. I'm not going to be specific about the address or the location. There's still a lot of stuff that we need to do. That's something that, you'll get this week.
Was your DNA evidence, what led you to the conclusion that the human remains were Debbie and that Mr. Griffith was the perpetrator?
Based on the tip that came in, based on the information that we had, based on the follow-up information that was done between the time that the tip was received, it became pretty evident that the remains that we found were our victims, and in fact our suspect was our suspect. Again, I can't be more specific than that because the investigation is ongoing. There may or may not be other arrests involved in this, so it would be, negligent on our part to get a little any deeper than that.
When the car was processed, or at the point of the last press conference, it hadn't fully been processed at that point, were his fingerprints or anything belonging to Mr. Griffith found in the vehicle?
At this point, again, I think that's something that we're going to have to stand mute on. That is part of the investigation. I will say this. And you guys have been around you've been around a long time. You know how investigations are conducted. There's a lot of things that come together that lead us to make arrests in cases like this that are complicated, where we don't initially have a body, and then we make an arrest. That's a piece of the puzzle, but there's more to it than that. And what this case boils down to is, again, it's a very complicated case. This was a very high profile case. We made an arrest on a suspect, and in the interest of providing a good prosecution, we can't go any deeper than what we're giving you right now.
Can you tell us where Mr. Griffith was taken into custody? Was it his home, and whether it was with or without incident?
He was taken into custody without incident. It's my understanding he was taken into custody at a property on the Strip. And he was booked into the Clark County Detention Center.
What state was the remains found in?
The remains were found last night, late last night.
Full body dismemberment?
I'm not going to go into that. Yeah.
What is the probable cause of death? Was she strangled?
I won't, that is not up to me to make that determination. The coroner will conduct autopsy Monday morning, and the coroner will come out with the cause and manner of death either Monday afternoon or Tuesday. That's not something that we get into.
Well, at least when Mr. Griffith leaves, that's maybe other
people.
Okay. when you all arrested Mr. Griffith last night, was he cooperative?
He was arrested without incident. I will say that. And again, I don't want to go any further into what he said or didn't say.
What leads you to believe that there may or may not be other suspects? Something that Mr. Griffith said, or?
Well, like I said, in any homicide case, and especially in cases like this, when we make an arrest, the case doesn't stop there. You know, we still, you know, continue to conduct an investigation. And we got, you know, numerous tips through Crime Stoppers and phone calls and things like that. There was numerous leads to follow up on. You know, again, we would be negligent if we believe that, you know, this was our only suspect. We have to take a look at the totality of circumstances. So that's why I said there may or may not be additional arrests in this case.
Do you think he had help?
It's possible, but at this point, it's too early to say.
Any motive?
Don't have a motive as of yet.
Was she pregnant at the time of her death?
Don't know that.
Where was he arrested exactly on the trip?
I'm not going to go into that. Sorry. I'm not going to say that. I mean, I'll just give you a...
Now that he's in custody, can you go into a little bit more facts as far as his background with her criminal history?
No. Not today. If you guys need that information, you know, we're going to... You know, later on this week, we'll have more answers for you. You know, obviously, that'll be part of it. You know, we have to do a thorough workup on him and her and what the relationship is. We'll be able to provide that with you. And I apologize for not being able to give you a lot, but, you know, the public needed to know, you know, that the arrest was made, and we'll have more answers during the week, and we'll be able to get that to you. And with that, I'll end it. All right.
Thank you very much.
Okay.